Baby mine, don't you cry. Baby mine, dry your eyes. Rest your head close to my heart, never to part, baby of mine.
You wouldn't be going for the Christmas market, would you there, Michael?
No.
No.
Drink your water.
Gulping my water. No. It's purely coincidental that
Your Honour.
They've released a DVD of Dumbo at this time of year.
Is it?
Yes. No, it truly is.
What about the other thing? I love the music from The Lion King, actually. I just do. I love it. It gets me all excited every time I hear it. Is that on it, too?
That's on my album. It's not on that. That's a particular DVD of Dumbo, which they made a video of
featuring
me.
Featuring Michael Crawford, as well.
Yes. And I'm the one with the small ears.
And the small nose.
And the small nose. and the rest of the album is really more contemporary. That's the only Salute to the Past, which is actually 60 years old.
Have they digitalised
it all up? Is that why
it's
they're
actually
re-releasing
one better
it?
Than me.
Now, have they cleaned it all up digitally and everything?
Yes.
All right. So your thing is that just a bunch of Disney tunes, more recent Disney tunes.
Yes.
And songs.
Randy Newman and
the
other one, Tim Rice. Elton John and Tim Rice, who did Lion King. There's some great music in there.
You're going into a massive new musical in New York quite soon. We'll talk about that in a second. But we've only seen you twice. We saw you in Barnum when you were playing Barnum, and we saw you in Las Vegas when you were in
Effects.
That's right, where you broke your hip and all that kind of stuff. And we never got a chance to ask you about this, but what did you do with yourself every night after you finished this big show in Las Vegas in this desert town? Where did you go out into the desert and sort of go to a hotel? How did you live? You must have been really lonely, I would have thought.
No. I mean, you were dealing with about 6,000 people a night with both houses, and so I used to go home about 12:30 at night. Mm-hmm. We'd finish, because they're very late there. Yeah. The last show started at 10:45, 11 o'clock, and then you'd take your makeup off, rush out to the Jeep, and you'd go home, and the temperature was 95 degrees at 12:30 at night. Yeah. And I lived on a golf complex. I don't play golf, but it was very quiet and peaceful and way off the the strip. Mm. In Vegas. And I grew tomatoes and
at 2 in the morning.
Yes. Well, the heat was extraordinary, but you had to water them about 5 times a day. And I remember I used to go home at say 1 o'clock, and I'd water the tomatoes. And the man next door came out with a rifle one night because he thought someone was because they carry guns.
They do that in the States.
Yeah.
But did you like Vegas? I mean, do you gamble, for instance? Did you ever sort of really go on the town?
No, I don't gamble. I've never gambled.
I don't know.
It's too hard to come by our money when we get it.
But didn't you hate Vegas? I mean, it's such an art. It's a horrible place.
I hated the strip, but yeah. I liked the job that I took on. Mm. I mean, it was a massive production, and I thought there's nowhere else in the world that you would get this kind of money to put into a show. It would just be out of the question here. I mean, the musical that we're doing on Broadway, I think, is about 12 million, which is massive.
Is that, I don't know, is that a lot? I mean, it sounds a lot.
Yeah.
Is that...
And the effects show was 45 million.
Good God.
And that was 6 years ago.
So you've gone cheap
then? I've gone down market now.
But just tell us about this musical you're going to do on Broadway, because it's about vampires, isn't it?
Yes.
Is it kind of gothic, a bit like Phantom, but this
has much more humour to it, because I wouldn't have gone for the same thing.
Not many laughs in Phantom.
No, there weren't, no, especially when things went wrong. But it was a very serious and romantic and passionate piece, but this is going to be, it's got very different kind of music, because Jim Steinman's written the music, who did all Meatloaf stuff. Total Eclipse of the Heart, that's in the show.
Right.
So the girl sings that, and I sort of accompany her in that.
So are you a vampire?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
This sounds like some big. It sounds great.
I'll give you a little nibble later.
The first time you said that to Judy. I overheard that time. I overheard that night. The what?
Shut up.
Yeah, sorry.
I should
comedy
never
moments.
Said
all right. It sounds to me as though.
We'll be back with you in a minute.
It sounds to me, right, is that what's happened there is in New York, a bunch of, like, cigar-chewing, you know, guys have got together and said, we need a new Phantom for Michael. I've got it. We'll make him a vampire. It's got that, as you said, that kind of gothic...
Oh, no, right? I don't think that. That's how it was done. This production was done originally in Austria, and I went and saw it, and I thought, I loved the music, but I didn't like the way the story went. And right. I think it's very amusing what one can do, because it's a fable, after all, sort of vampire stories, to me, are fables.
They're always erotic, aren't they? They're always...
And camp.
Well, I do hope so, but they promised me that, But there is, I mean, he just, the way I want to play this character is far more outrageous, it's a curse to be, to live forever. Because I had a little trouble with this, morally as well, the kind of story about good and evil. Mm. But if I think it's done in a certain way, I think it can be extremely entertaining
so
in
are
a different
you basically,
kind of way.
Like Phantom, I mean, Phantom was this terribly damaged man who'd been turned into a monster by fate, and inside was a loving man. And we see in the final scenes of Phantom that man triumphs over his soul. Are we saying the same thing about your vampirical character? Is it really a poor soul who was once bitten by another vampire and can't help what he is?
Well, I believe that. Yes, I do. Because I
can't believe we're having this conversation.
Why not?
I don't. No, it's a very good question. I mean, because you can do it either way. There can be any of us as humans can be born and we can become evil. There are evil people that we're witnessing in the world at the moment. Mm. But I think we have a choice as to whether we grow up and develop ourselves into something that's decent in life.
So it's a kind of elaborate metaphor with music and fun. And eroticism.
Yeah. Meet your new publicist.
That'll do.
Mike, it's lovely to see you.
Thank you.
Again.
It's lovely to
we
see you.
We saw, when you were on Parky, we saw there was sort of your ex-wife in the audience. Are you getting back together?
No.
Oh, right. I just wondered, you're obviously still.
I just came in for a quiet chat.
But you're still a good mate, aren't you?
There go the payments again.
I was just curious. Sorry.
No. All right, darling, I'll be home soon.
Thanks, right. Michael.
Thank
you. Lovely
Thank
to see you.
Judy.
Now over to our real life Bridget Jones, who has a bad track record with relationships. All she wants for Christmas is a man, a nice man, who won't let her down.
Michael?
Oh, look, they're like this to each other across the studio.
Eye contact.
All week, she's been picking...